Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Arc. A couple things have happened since the last episode. Let's see. Oh, okay. Apparently there's a new icon. I didn't know about that. That must have been in the update that I literally just downloaded. Shows who's feeding. That's very useful. But yeah, I set up a little trough here, feeding trough, and then just piled all my meat eaters around here. Just because feeding meat eaters is a serious problem because of the fact that meat, a 20 stack of meat decays in, oh, I think it lasts 20 minutes, I think. So you're looking at 400 minutes. That's only like math work, please. What, like 7 hours? 6 hours and 40 minutes. And if you're going to bed, then, by the time it wakes up, by the time you wake up, your dinosaur's gonna be out of food. Your meat eaters, at least. And there are other solutions. You could try putting like cooked prime meat on them, because that stuff has like a timer of 45 minutes, and then it stacks. I'm pretty sure it stacks up to 100. I've never actually got that high. And then you've got a good bit. So, but because I just figure, every time I come on, we'll just load up some more meat, go a quick bit of hunting. Obviously on earlier. We're getting so many dodo eggs. But yeah, so I tamed, I think, a couple more dodos. I tamed another Pulmoscorpius, a male, because we already had a female. I'm pretty sure I'd already made the tornado saddle, but if I hadn't, then I had, then I've made one, and I plan to make another one. I just need to like grab some fiber and stuff, but I'll do that in a minute. So yeah, we've got both of these. I'm still continuing to pump water. On this one, I am pumping stamina, so it's up to 420. And on this one, I'm pumping weight, so it's up to 174. Now, weight isn't going to be particularly useful, but it is going to allow us to sort of get a little bit more. Like that's 24 more crystal right there before we can't move. That's useful. I tamed up an argent. It's just because I love this one. It's like an albino one with sort of a red cap on it, and I don't know what it is, but I just love the way this looks. Oh, getting some frame drops. Sorry about that. Come on, frames. Please come back. Please. Yeah, okay, there we go. We lost our Fiomia. Frames are dropping again. They can't just make us smile. We lost our Fiomia, but Amnesiac is now our berry storage over here. Yeah, everything's fine. And yeah, so that's what's been going on there. We've got some plants going, obviously. Fertilizer on them. Just quickly double check the numbers, it's all good. Yeah, I can always add some more in the future. I'm pretty sure I already had that saber tooth. If I didn't, then I tamed a saber saber tooth. Sorry about that. Yeah, he's just being my hunting buddy just now. He's very useful. Was it not for the fact that it's a mammal, then I'd be going, "Oh, and it's a female, yay!" But as it's a mammal, they don't lay eggs. Oh, speaking of which, the argent harvest is actually a mammal. No, not a mammal, a female. Oh, got level. Yeah, just pumping a bit of weight. Health is now. But yeah, so I did get another Dilophosaurus. I got this one. So now these are mate boosted, so we're getting a lot more eggs. We already had the mate boosted dodos. Now I've got Pteranodons, Pulmoscorpius. So we're getting a lot of eggs. Obviously, then we've got our mate boosted Stegos, which we already had. Mate boosted Trikes, which we already had. Mate boosted Parasaurs, which we already had. Then we've got mate boosted Turtles. So you can see, I'm very much trying to get the mate boosted for the eggs. But yeah, I tamed a Spino. This was because, all right, mate, he was just lying around and he was attacking stuff, and I was like, "That's such a waste of a Spino." He's just running around doing stuff, and I was like, "Okay." And I tell you what, Spino's torpor goes down like nothing you've ever seen. If you've never tamed a Spino, then I'm just gonna give you advice. Pack a lot of narcotics. Like, seriously. I think I put like 80 on this guy just to stop him from waking up. Yeah. But there is something I wanted to discuss with you. Just get a couple little opinions on this. I'm just going to be doing some stuff in the background while I do it, while I just talk about it. So I just want to discuss the fact that Arc is getting harder. And this is a problem because of the fact that it kind of screws over new players, in my opinion. Because I'll explain what I mean. If you had got Ark out, basically, obviously metaphorically, out the box, then it wasn't ridiculously hard. There was Rexes and stuff, but generally generally you'd be set up on the beach, and so you wouldn't really have problems with them. But then they added more stuff. They just made it harder and harder and harder. Like, because, like I said, at the beginning it wasn't particularly hard. There were some hard dinos, but it wasn't anything brutal. But then they added the likes of the bugs, like the Myrnimas. And they're not exactly hard, but they are annoying, very annoying. And they have admittedly killed me a couple times in the past. Just, when I've been really low health after killing something, and then they just appear and they just kill me. Just take off that last little bit of health. And then they added the Meganuras, which did the same, but they're even stronger than the Myrnimas, rather they're called. And, that just makes it tougher. I don't get why. It's kind of screwing over new players. Oh, god, sorry, more frame loss. And then they added the Alphas. And it's like, these can spawn basically anywhere, and they will wreck your face. Ah, cancel this out. There we go. And I just don't get it. It's like, you're basically screwing over anyone who now goes and buys the game. You know? And yeah, it kind of seems weird to me. I mean, I get they want to add more dinos, and to do that they gotta add tougher dinos, otherwise it kind of becomes redundant. But, and they go to the Gigantos, and if you get too close to them, they're gonna wreck your face. It's like, eh? And yeah. I did also want to discuss the fact that their name they seem to be choosing names that are very hard to pronounce, because, like, pre any sort of updates or anything, I think it's fair to say the hardest thing to say was the Dilophosaurus. Those little tiny things I've got over there. But then they had the Myrnimers, then the Meganuras, then the Gigantopithecus, then the Mesopithecus, and the one they've got coming out in the near future. Oh my god! I don't even know where to start in pronouncing that. If you've not seen it, go check out like the trailer on the likes of Slipgear's channel or something. I'm pretty sure Ark has their own channel, but I've not been able to find it anywhere. I haven't really looked really. But yeah, it's just I don't even know where to start pronouncing that. Oh god, sorry about the frame loss. But yeah, that dino does actually quite interest me because it seems to be a taming dino. If you look at the trailer closely, you can see the fact that when it charges at the parasaur, it doesn't kill it. It knocks it over. There's no blood or anything, which is what happens when it takes damage. So what must be happening is it knocked it out very cleanly as well. It did, it knocked out the parasaur and it wasn't even slightly bloody. And that interests me. Being able to tame something basically without doing it damage. That's insanity. That would be awesome for taming. You get a really good one of those and GG. Yeah. I've got a metal to. No. Have I got metal in here? Yes, but I'm not gonna use it. But yeah, just the whole getting harder and harder kind of seems weird to me. Just. They should be adding some stuff to make it easier as well. Like, alphas should be optional, in my opinion. Sorry. Like, the whole crosshairs are optional. If you look on this server, we don't have them enabled. On some servers or on single play, you can choose to enable a crosshair, which would be like right in the middle, and just be a crosshair, show you how to use it. But instead, you got AMM, which isn't bad, but. And I think alphas should just be like that. It's just because they're so tough. Oh, sorry. Like I mentioned a couple episodes ago, or like happened a couple episodes ago, an alpha raptor killed my T-Rex, and it wasn't even like close to death. It wasn't a case of oh, it had like 3 hit points left. It was a case of it still had enough health to go kill a raptor and a Dicarus easily. Yeah, it just Ark baffles me sometimes. Just because how OP the alphas are. And then there's the alpha rexes, and god, I mean, I've never directly come in contact with one, but similar videos, oh my god, Like people sending in armies of T-Rexes and losing like half of them. They're insane. And all you seem to get is like, maybe, oh, a cool crossbow or something, but you'll lose a bunch of your dinos and you might get a thing, a helmet skin. You know? It just. I'm probably missing something, but yeah, it just kind of doesn't make sense to me. Frames, please come back. Yeah. But oh god. But I think I'm gonna just sort of go and do some stuff and then we'll be back. I mean, I think I've been over what happened since last episode. Yeah. Okay, I'll be back. And welcome back. And I just went over to have a bit of a visit with Seleucus. Had a bit of a chat. It was quite nice. And yeah, I took up some resources, and he was able to make me a couple things, which is really good. Sorry about the frames. I don't know what's going on all of a sudden. Doesn't seem too bad, but yeah. Yeah, I was able to get a primitive mammoth saddle and a primitive ankylosaddle, saddle, which is really good. So now we can ride these. And the ankylosaur we're going to be able to take up onto the mountain and get like metal on that. Oh god, really sorry about the frames. I don't know what's going on. But yeah, the mammoth we can after we quickly get some water so that we don't pass out, because I don't fancy passing out around here, or well, anywhere to be fair. Passing out's just an annoyance. But yeah, so we can now hop on what can be now deforestation. Just come over here and wreck trees. We can now get wood, which is really good. So you see, look at that wood count. We're already at 180, 200. This is a very nice way of getting wood. See, so much quicker. And then if we want thatch, we can either just take our pick or hop on like the stego or something. You see, we cleared that space in no time and got 100, 200, 313 wood and some berries, but we don't really care about berries much. Yeah, and then we've got the ankylo. Again, sorry if the frames seem a bit stuttery. I'm really sorry. It seems to be second light, so 24-ish. And that is smooth sometimes, but depends on it. So if it's seeming a bit stuttery, I'm very sorry. But yeah, the ankylo can do that. He can beat up rocks for us. And admittedly, down here he's only getting stone and flint, which while it is useful, it's not amazing. But we're gonna be able to take him up to onto the mountain and get tons of like metal, which is gonna be really nice. Yeah, but he actually also works for berries. Just a bit of advice, this a lot of people seem to not know. Anything that's a herbivore can be used as a gatherer. I mean, think about it. How do you think they would have got food anyway? But yeah, we got 6 metal. Where's it? Oh, it's okay. 33 stone and 29 flint, so that's not bad. But yeah, a lot of people don't seem to realize you can use any herbivore as a gatherer. Even like parasaurs. I mean, they're not very good at it, but if you just come over here. Oh, go line up. See? Just something that a lot of people don't seem to not know. So, you can't even use like parasaurs. You can use turtles. I'm pretty sure you can use Fiomias as well. Just, they're not amazingly good at it. So yeah, big thank you to Mr. Seleucia, sorry, for helping me out with that. Yeah, so I will be back when something interesting happens. And welcome back. And as you can see, we're just doing a little bit of hunting. Me and my saber tooth. I needed a name for him. Not been able to think of one. Yeah, I generally just run around and just like, target stuff with the crossbow. It basically becomes like a laser designator almost. And then just let him kill it. Then I harvest up the hide. But yeah, I am now going to make one of these. Because I got the blueprint for the water jars. Which is good, because they're like 12 engram points or something. That means I no longer need to use water skins. because one water jar actually has the contents of a water skin. So, nope. There we go. What did that do to you? I don't want you in your troll, I want you to attack my target. So, kill. Kill Fang. But yeah, so a water skin holds like one sort of charge of water, I guess. It holds like 100 water, while a water jar holds 200, so you'll be able to drink from it twice. Plus, it doesn't even leak, which is really nice. But yeah, I was completely out of hide because I had to basically spend all the hide I had to bring Seleucia the. The. Oh my god. Words, please! The resources, that's it. The resources needed to make the saddles, the mammoth one and the ankylosaur one. Just because obviously, it'd be kind of unfair for him to have to make like saddles for everyone on the server. God, I'm so sorry about the frames. I don't know what's going on. I really don't. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna have to get this fixed. We're sitting like 20. Okay, it's going up. But yeah, so I have gone. I've done a bit of wood harvesting, not a ton, but you know. I think I've got like 500-600 wood now, give or take. But yeah, having a water jar is gonna just make life easier, just cause mainly cause they don't leak, you know. That's one of my main problems with water skins, is that the water just gradually leaks out. Ooh, eggs. I've got so many eggs, like it's literally got to the point with dodo eggs that I'm just eating them. I'm not even putting them in my preserving bin, because I've already got 100 of them. 4 eggs from one dodo. Oh my god. There's something wrong with these spawn rates. I mean, seriously, this is just stupid. 13. Oh. Come on. Like, 13 eggs, I think that was. Yeah, 13 eggs. But we did get an argent egg, an argent harvest egg, which is really nice. And I got our first one of those. And you know, we'd be wanting those. Because those can make. A kibble for spinos. And you know, we're gonna want to get into some high level spinos eventually. How long was the weight down by? Oh, they're probably all the dodo eggs. They get heavy very quickly. But yeah, if we look in this preserving bin over here. Yeah, 100 dodo eggs. So I'm just not putting any more in. Quite simple. When I get 100, I'm happy. So I'm just eating them. And yeah, as you see, we've got our nice argent egg, which is really nice. And because they are extremely rare for us. What is so heavy in my inventory? Maybe the wood. Yeah, so what we're also going to want to do is in the future we're going to get like a male argent as well. Or well, more females, but you know, just because we want to have the mate boosted. Oh, come on. How come this works on some things but it doesn't on others? You then have to do it manually, which is so annoying. Yeah, so 541 wood is not bad at all, I'd say. God, I'm so sorry. I think I'm probably gonna turn down my settings for the next cut. But yeah, I mean, like the textures aren't even loading in just now. It's so weird. Oh, there we go. Yay. But yeah, I'm gonna be back when something else interesting happens. That's one mighty poop. And welcome back. Now, a good little bit has happened since the last cut. Oh, sorry, breathing into the mic. Firstly, I did a big mining run. I'm just gonna look so this way to avoid a spoiler. We'll get to in a second. And I actually took the amnesiac and the spinosaurus and stickless stones all up. So, you know, stickless stones being there to gather metal, spino being there to give us cover, and the amnesiac to carry it all. And he, boy, did he carry it all. I came back with something like 600 metal. I think I've got all of it off him. Yeah. But also like 400, 400 flint, 500 stone, and that 25 obsidian. Amazing run. But yeah, so I smelted all that up. And I've made a couple things. Just gonna put these recipes. I'll get to those in a second because those are really cool how I got those. But I actually ended up making something that you may or may not have noticed already, depending how vigilant you are. If you look at the number 9 slot in my inventory, you can see I made a long neck rifle. Just a primitive one, nothing special. You know, just the engram. But this thing is awesome. Firstly, the XP it gives, Jesus Christ. It's like a god with that. I mean, just look at it, it's just repairing it, 775, 8806. That was about 30, 31, was it, XP, just for repairing it. I think it was about 95 to actually make it. Yeah, I've been trying to keep these just like stocked up with wood and keep them burning, just for charcoal, because as you may or may not know, I generally use gunpowder, not gunpowder, spark powder for my fuel. So when it came to making bullets, I realized I have no charcoal, and so you know I couldn't really make gunpowder. So I literally just got a bunch of wood with deforestation, put it on this like four slots of it, and just went and got lunch. And when I came back, I had a few hundred gunpowder, and so I was able to make a whole load of bullets. A lot of which I've already used, because this thing is great fun. But I also got the scope attachment. I'm actually just gonna quickly show you what it takes. So it's like 95 metal ingots. That's not too bad once you've got like the setup that I do with stickless stones, amnesiac, and that. It's not too horrible. Wood, that's fine. Hide only 25, not a problem. The ammo is quite annoying. It's 2 metal ingots and 12 gunpowder. Now that is 2 bullets, but still. That's a lot of gunpowder and a lot of metal ingots. But yeah, they are very good XP. For each craft of those, it's like 1.5 XP, which, considering how many you'll be crafting, is not bad at all. But yeah, I also unlocked. I also got the scope attachment, as you can see, like just in the bottom right there. Like, it's in my hotbar thing. You can see it's got the little picture of the scope, that means it's attached. And this wasn't too bad. It's another 40 metal ingots, another 5 stone, and I did have to go up to the mountain just on my pteranodon to get some crystal. So you know, it wasn't too horrendous, but that's good. Speaking of pteranodons, oh, this is gonna be awkward. I actually tamed another one. Smaug is over there, being all awkward. Where is he? Come on, you're somewhere around here, I know it. Dodos. There he is. He just called Pteranodon, but yeah, he's a level 22, so he's a good bit better than the other ones. I tamed him with a kibble, just because I've got it. And yeah, I actually gave away my other Pteranodon, because this is a male, and we don't need two males. It's kind of pointless. Actually, that reminds me, I want to bring Smaug back over here so she can be mate boosted. It occurred to me I named the female Smaug, and you know, Smaug is a male. A male wyvern, not dragon. I don't care what anyone says. I've been pumping stamina on Smaug. I've been doing the same on Pteranodon. So he's up to 540, that's not too bad. Yeah, a lot of his points, unfortunately, were just naturally put into melee damage, which did end up actually coming in quite useful. Because the reason he was actually like level 20 a minute ago, but I managed to get 2 levels on him really easily. Because I went over to Seleucius's, and I'll explain what I did there in a minute. But on the way back, I just happened to see a Spino that was practically dead, and I just did the barrel roll thing, you know, when you press C, and it killed him. So I got the XP for Spino on my Pteranodon, which was insane. But yeah, while I was over at Seleucius's, I took up resources, obviously, and he gave me this. Not the sabertooth, the sabertooth is mine, but the saddle, which is amazing. Because if you don't know, first of all, I love the jump. You can't even jump upwards, it has to be forwards. It's kind of weird, but yeah, the reason I love sabertooths, or saberteeth, is because they're basically the axe of the dino world. And if you don't know what I mean, when you harvest like a dino corpse, like say you killed a Dillo, even just a Dillo, if you were to use a pickaxe, you get mostly meat. if you use an axe, you get mostly hide. That's fairly common knowledge by this point. At least the wrong one. But generally people don't realize that for meat, you're going to be using like, sort of, I think meat is like raptors, carnos, and rexes, those three. Hide is a saber. Sabers, I believe, are like the only one that is probably good for like hide and chitin and that. Then you got like the higher tier ones, like scorpions, I think, are just basically well rounded. Spiners, I think, are just rounded again. I think the rest of them are just sort of well rounded. But yes, that means I can now get a ton of hide, which is so good. I did put saddles on both my scorpions, the one over here and the one that's for some reason over here. Oh yeah, because I went hunting with them. God, everything's so loud. Since the newest update, everything, like all my settings reset. So everything was at like settings that I can't play at. And God, the volume. I wear headphones and by God, my ears are practically bleeding. Sorry about the frames, I don't know what's happening. Because there was, I could have sworn it was optimized. Yeah, my computer is being a bit annoying. But yeah, so there was actually a big chunk of optimization in the last update, and that was really nice, because, I mean, I noticed it the moment I came on. I put my settings back to what they should be, and the first thing I said was just optimization. Yeah. Which is amazing. But yeah, I've lost my train of thought completely. Yeah, I'm now at level 42, because I made saddles for both these scorpions. I had to make another saddle for the pteranodon. The other saddle, I'm not gonna say, the other pteranodon, I'm not gonna say where he is just now. Probably I'll say it next episode, just because it's a bit of a spoiler. Because I don't know if, I don't know how to word this without spoiling, so I'm just not gonna. You'll find out what happened to him next episode, probably. But yeah, I also made three of these saddles, because these saddles are horribly expensive. I don't get why they're so expensive for a dino that sucks. I mean, I get these guys are quite tanky. I mean, you know, I've been pumping health on them, and they've got like 2,500 each, but, oh, maybe not that. But still, they've got a lot of health each. But I wouldn't say their saddles are even close to worth the price. Because I'm just going to quickly level these guys, and then I'll show you how much what the saddle costs, and it's insane. Let me just quickly run back here. Amnesiac standing on the roof again, as he does. But yeah, I've got a blueprint for it rather than the engram, which is quite nice. But look at this. 292 hide, 163 fiber, and 17 cementing paste. Oh my god. Oh god. It's like painful. I'm already having nightmares about cementing paste. And if you don't know what I'm on about, get even kind of late game with Ark and you'll find out. But yeah, being the level that I am, I made some gasoline. Just cause I can. And being the level that I am, I was able to unlock the Fabricator, so that's what I'm working towards now. It's kind of expensive, and well, it's not that bad. I've basically got everything minus the fact that I need one more cementing paste and some more crystal and a bit more spark powder. Spark powder is not expensive. So what I'm going to do next is I'm actually going to go up onto the mountain on my Pteranodon, my level 22, grab a bit of crystal, then I'm going to try and find, I'm probably going to like, kill something that, actually, you know, I'll probably just go up on my saber. Because he can get me a bit of chitin or something on the way. Or keratin. But yeah, it means that I'm now able to get chitin, keratin, those two especially, but hide also, at a much better rate. I love the sound in fact it makes when he jumps. One problem is his stamina isn't great. I'm going to have to level that a bit. Only 220 stamina. That is not... Oh wait, he's got keratin on him. Sweet. I'm not going to bother taking him, it would be much faster to get crystal just by going up on my Pteranodon. But yeah, we've got enough keratin. I'm sorry about the frame drop, I don't know what's going on. One second. Sorry, just another bit of a coughing fit. I just checked my settings. I actually had my render distance slightly higher than I should, so I'm gonna attribute it to that. But yeah, I'm just gonna ride my saber just because I can over here to grab some stone, because we're gonna build the fabricator this cut, unless I have another coughing fit. Sorry about the frames again. I don't know what's happening. I am truly sorry for that. I don't know. It's just Ark is still a fairly intensive game, especially at medium graphic settings, but I don't want to turn it down to low. Everything else is at like minimum, but I don't want to set the detail down to low, because then it actually looks god-awful. Yeah, so we can get that crafting. We can also get that spark powder crafting, come to think of it. Ooh. But yeah, I'm going to get on Pteranodon. I need to think of a name for this guy. Is he good? Yeah, we're good. And we're just going to fly. What's all the way? Oh yes, my long neck rifle. It weighs 15. Oh my god, it's so heavy. But I still don't want to put it down because it's so awesome. I wish you could shoot guns or crossbow or just do anything on the back of a mount. Because currently all you can really do is, I think you can emote. Yeah. Oh, I for God's sake, I reset those. I want it to be that one. I'm gonna have to figure out how I set that now, because I did it by accident before. But yeah, I wish you could, like, you can, because currently all you can do is use a spyglass and your map. And that's kind of annoying. I mean, that is two good things to use. Don't get me wrong. But I want to be able to, like, shoot a gun. I want to go hunting on the back of my guy. I mean, I know you can have, like, people carry you. I've actually seen that happen, but you can have people carry you, and then while you're being carried, you can still shoot your gun. And that seems kind of awesome, but the problem is then finding someone to carry you. And yeah, I mean, I know that's a very, very good technique for taking down really high-level things, like, you know, level 120 Rexes, which we don't have yet. Actually, no, I'm going to want that. What am I doing? I think we need a little more. We have 6, I think. I'm just going to get a couple extra just in case. Don't have to come back. You know, just yet. You know, that'll be fine. But yeah, what you can do is you can have, like, it can be on a Pteranodon or an Argent Harvest. You just have the guy riding the mount actually pick up the other guy. And then the other guy can use his crossbow or whatever, and he can just unload Trank Darts into, like, a Rex. And like I said, we don't have 120 Rexes. So Lucius did raise up the difficulty, thankfully, because it means we can get some slightly higher level dinos. But I believe the highest level that can spawn in our world just now is level 80, I think. Which is quite nice, you know. And I've noticed a difference right off the bat, because I think before, the max level must have been like 30 or something. Actually, probably like 40, because I believe Estelucius had found a level 40 Carno. Like early on in the series. Come on, please get down. Hey, for God's sake. Okay. But yeah, now we can go into here, and we can just do a bit of jumping. Put that in there, make up some spark powder. That's not going to be enough. We're going to have to go get some more stone. But yeah, this should be us. Oh, God damn it. God damn it. I could have sworn I had 6, not, like, 2. It's very annoying. But yeah, like I said, I want to do it in this cut. I'm not giving up. I'm gonna go back. Yeah. Power and stuff. Dedication. When you set your mind to do something, just do it. Shia LaBeouf style. Oh, God. See, now I've completely lost my train of thought. That's something I'm very good at. Just, you know, I think of something like, okay, I need to mention this. I can talk about this for a few minutes, you know, just as a bit of a filler while I'm doing something. Because obviously I can't make an episode out of, like, you know, these out of, like, 20-second cuts. I need to actually talk and do stuff. Otherwise, there's not a chance in hell I can even get close to making one a day. Oh, God, Saber's on the top. Pteranodon will easily die from a Saber. No doubt about that. So I'm just gonna quickly... Give me crystal. Okay, that's enough. Come on. We're out. Yeah. I like to try and think of things I can talk about, so that way I have something to talk about. You know, as a filler. So it means I can do things like this. Ooh, look at that little pond over there. Yeah, just above the little sort of tip of the Triadon. Looks so cool. But yeah, I like to be able to have things I can talk about just so that I'm not rambling like I basically do. Like I am just now. Because rambling seems to be all I end up doing. And it's a problem because I'm so good at losing my train of thought. I really should write them down. But you know, that would be too easy. I wouldn't want to make it too easy for myself, would I now? So this should be enough for, come on. And there we go. I think that's everything we need to make a fabricator. I made some gasoline. It's very easy to make. It's just some oil and some stuff. Oh, no, we made it. Oh, and we're able to make the gasoline using oil. Thanks to, once again, thanks to Deathbringer's very generous donation. Still using it, using it very sparingly. But yeah, I made a little gasoline, not too much. But is it? Yes, we can make it. That's going to be a whole lot of XP, so let's keep an eye on this. 8814.7. Oh, it was 30 XP. That it? You're kidding me. I'm very unimpressed by that XP count. Can I put this in the core? Oh god, it's bigger than I thought. Where do I want to put this? I'm going to... I want to leave a bit more space for preserving bins to go up along here, but I want to leave space for large storage boxes to go up along here. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to put it here. Go see how far we can go back. And there we go. We have a fabricator. It's got a big inventory, but there's nothing we can make in it. So, I mean, I may as well just put the gasoline in it, because gasoline is required to run it. But, there's not anything I can craft. Yeah, so, I'll be back in a minute with whatever we're going to do next. But yay, we have a fabricator. Awesome! And yeah, so looking at time, this is actually going to be the end of the episode. But first, just, you know, make sure you never look down the barrel of a gun. It's very dangerous. Aww, I was hoping they would shoot it. But anyway, thank you for watching. If you did enjoy the video, then please smash that like button. If you want to see more from me, then hit that subscribe button. If you want to leave advice, feedback, or just say hello, the comments are right down there. Go ahead and follow me on Twitter. Link should be in the description, hopefully. And yeah, I will see you all next time. Wait. Bye! He holds the rifle. It actually looks quite cool.